Kevin, the postcard guy, here at Allaire Park in New Jersey. Just going picking today. Today is the first Allaire flea market of the season. So we're going to check it out. It is around, I guess around 7 o'clock. And we're going to see what we can find. So check in a little bit and I'll let you know. It's time for the second market. Just left the Allaire and I'm here at Route 70 today. A little chilly, 30s out here, but there are some dealers set up. So let me take a walk around, see what I can find. Hi guys, this is Kevin the Postcard Guy back from my two flea markets I was at this morning. It's early in March, so flea markets are just starting up here in New Jersey. So the dealers are kind of light, the buyers are kind of light, so you got a good chance of finding some stuff. So here's what I found today. I like to buy brand new videos when I can find them. These were $3 for $5. Leaves me a little bit of room. They're all factory sealed. So I picked those up. This little World Fair tip tray, 1964, 1965 New York World Fair was just 50 cents. So I couldn't pass that up. These were kind of neat. These were all space patches. Mercury 9, Cooper, Mercury 3, Shepard, Freedom, Sierra, Mercury, Mercury 7, Grissom, Liberty Bell 7. This one here is the Space Shuttle with McAuliffe, Jarvis, Smith, Scobie, Resnick, McNair, and Onizuka. These were a buck a piece, and he took 5 for all of them, so I think I got a good deal on those. Anything space is very collectible these days, so I was happy to get those. These, I just happened to stop by the Dollar Tree, the dollar store on the way home. These are How to Draw Vampires. I saw similar ones online for $5.99 each. So for a buck a piece, I picked those up. I picked up this little tiki inspired mug. It's milk glass. It says Hawaii and Texas, Hawaii Kai. And it's got the hula dancers, some porpoises or dolphins jumping. And again, this is really nice. And it was just $1. So I couldn't pass that up. Anything Hawaiian or tiki, I'll pick up. This here was just $1 as well. Harvey's Lake Tahoe. Again, considered a tiki mug or a tiki cup. It's got the tiki guys on there. Still got a little bit of a foil sticker on the bottom. And for $1, couldn't go wrong. Looks like somebody was maybe using it as a planter for one time. But it is a tiki mug from the resort. So I picked that up for $1. These are all 50 cents or less a piece. These are all annual reports from the 50s from all different companies. I figured maybe people who like advertising might like these, but here's Textron, annual report, Electro Auto Light Company. Some of them are car related. 1957, Merck and Company, Textron, 1957. Pullman, who made train cars, which is kind of neat, 1957. Most of them do have photographs inside of different train cars and things. So they could be very collectible. So for 50 cents, I think I did well. General Tire, Crane, Jupiter Oil, United States Freight Company, which has old 50s trucks inside, which is really cool. Monarch, Rock Island Railroad, Standard Brands, Ford Motor Company, all different kind of shareholder things. Here's Ford Motor Company for 57. And again, they got Ford executives, Ford cars, some nice color pictures. So these are very collectible. I think for 50 cents, I couldn't go wrong. Ford tractors, all the different kinds of stuff. Union Carbide, Pullman Incorporated, Consolidated Natural Gas, Rayon Corporation, Mage Fabric, Pullman Railroad again, and Well Built. So the big stack I got very reasonable. It was less than 50 cents a piece when I averaged them out and bought the whole box. Over here, these are an old store ledger from upstate New York. It's dated 1880s and 1890s inside, so I have to go through and do some more research on that, but maybe somebody from that hometown is looking for old collectibles. This book I thought was really good. This is Zimmerman on Training with Points for Cyclists. It's a very early cycling book, 50 cents. For something from the 1890s, that was a lot of money. And it shows the champion of America and England on the front. And it is a little bit of rough shape. The binding needs a little bit of repair, but it is really a cool book on cycling, very, very, very early. And it talks about how to ride, ladies cyclists, safeties, tricycles, tandem tricycles, gear cases, mud guards, cranks, how to clean your bike, how to oil your bike. Really neat stuff. And in the very back, what I found very interesting is all the early bike ads, which I think are very good. There's Reading, PA bicycling, French tires, Paragons, all different kinds of bicycle advertising. That was just $5 for the book. I think I did well with that. I bought a big stack of auto literature. These are 60s and 70s car literature for Volkswagens. Very collectible. These average out to about 50 cents a piece. 69 Plymouth Barracuda. This is, I think, one of the better ones. This is actually VW buses. I know VW buses themselves sell for a lot of money, so the advertising in turn should also do as well. And again, these average about 50 cents to a buck a piece. Volkswagen again. Early Jeeps. All nice color brochures showing all the different models, all the vintage advertising. I love this kind of stuff myself. Something like this I would expect to be in the $5 to $10 range. Traction. This is early racing. Shows different things. Racing, motorcycle racing. So that's very interesting. And then one of the best finds I think I had was this big box of Disneyland magazines. These are all from the 60s and 1970s. They were put out for Disneyland out in California. They're great. They have nice bright colors, all different comics inside, advertisements for Disneyland Park, different attractions. So I did very well with this box. What's kind of neat is there's all different dates and different topics. So like here's Mickey going trailer camping. Here's Pinocchio. But what's interesting is when you look through, there's a lot of duplication. So there's like two of each, which is kind of weird. There are some girls' names written on some of them, which is kind of a takeaway. It's going to take away a little bit of the value. So Cindy and Jill. So I'm guessing Cindy got a magazine and Jill got one as well. So I'm guessing this is Cindy's, this is Jill's. But yeah, there are actually two of each one if I go through them and take a look. So yeah, there's two Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. There's two of everything inside, which is kind of neat because I can list them once. And if the condition's the same, I can just say two available. So in here, I counted quickly. I thought there was about 50 of them. The gentleman wanted $2 a piece. I told him that was way too much. I couldn't go that much. I was going to resell them for, say, starting at $1.99 or $2 a piece. So we settled on a buck a piece. So this stack here, I paid $50 for. It is a huge stack. Actually, when I got back to the car and fine counted them, there's over 75. So I did a little bit less than a buck piece. And like I said, every single one has two different of the same issue. So there's two of that, two of everything inside, both from Cindy and Jill. So I think these are very collectible. I got to do a little bit more research on them. I collect Disney World ones myself. These are Disneyland. So it's not something I want to keep for myself. So these will be going up for sale. So all in all, a lot of paper goods today. I hit two markets, the Allaire Flea Market in Farmingdale, New Jersey, and the Route 70 Flea Market in Lakewood, New Jersey. And once again, they're just starting up for the season. So people are getting a little bit of cabin fever and wanting to get out and sell some stuff. So I got some really good deals and some great sales stock. So if you like what you see, make sure you like and subscribe. I am the postcard guy here in New Jersey. I'm happy to help anybody if I can in any way. But make sure you like and subscribe and stop back often to see what the postcard guy finds. Thanks. Have a great weekend.